Fly me to the moon. Let me play among the stars. Let me see what spring is like on Jupiter and Mars. In other words, hold my hand. In other words, baby, kiss me. Fill my heart with song. Let me sing for
it. Suspect is Eddie Booth, charged with first-degree murder of his wife and son, Cindy and Carter Booth. Method of murder, strangulation, he stabbed his little boy. No prior record.
Doesn't look like a killer to me, man.
What do you think killers look like, Stanley?
Well, with the world going to shit as it is, nothing would surprise me.
Amen to that. Well, I'll leave you to it then. See if you can get out of them and report back to me anything you got. Have fun.
Oh, good morning. And what may I call you?
I'm Stanley, Detective Joseph Stanley. Look, I don't want to take up too much of your time with this.
Oh, no, no, no. Don't you worry. I get it. You want to get to the meat and the potatoes of this situation. Go on.
So it says here that you're responsible for the murder of your wife and son.
That's right.
Well, let's start from the beginning. Tell me, why did you do it?
Well, have you seen the weather? I couldn't just possibly keep myself cooped up all day. I had to find something to do. And one morning, I woke up and whoop-de-doo, I guess.
Ah, so it was boredom then. Why did you do it?
Didn't I just tell you? Why do you drink?
What are you talking about?
You know exactly what I'm talking about.
What the hell does that have to do with anything?
You put crooks like me behind bars. And yet you think that your job grants you some kind of immunity from your past sins? Mr. Stanley, who's going to be putting you behind bars?
So you've got me all figured out, don't you?
Oh, Mr. Stanley, we've just met. I can't wait to learn more about you.
I'd like to learn why you did it.
Are you a man of God, Mr. Stanley?
Answer the goddamn question.
Are you a man of God?
If God existed, the streets would be a lot cleaner, and we wouldn't be having this conversation.
Are you his Samaritan? His instrument to making sure the world stays how it is?
What the fuck is your point?
My point is, Mr. Stanley, that I'm the thing that makes you the best version of you. I'm just the air beneath your wings, the yin to your yang. Do you know what made my job easy?
What?
Kids don't struggle. My wife, on the other hand, well, we'll put it this way, she was like a wet cat.
You sick?
Now, enough about me. Let's talk about you. Do you have a family? A daughter?
Son?
Oh, that's too bad. I'm sure he would have gotten along with mine very well. I would have loved to meet him.
You stay the hell away from my son.
I wonder if he would have cooperated as easily as my son did.
Stop talking about my son!
Whoa, Mr. Stanley. I didn't mean anything by it.
I've had enough! I knew this was gonna be a complete waste of my fucking time. You make me sick! You're gonna rot in here and never see the light of day.
I'm sorry, sir, but I need to go.
The hell's the matter? What did he tell you?
Not a goddamn word. He started talking to me like I was his pal off the street. Got a big smile on his face the whole time like it was some sort of joke.
My God.
I need to take an early day today. I need some time to think.
Of course. I mean, anything you need, let me know. Sorry I put you through that, man. Just go get some rest for now. Take care of yourself, Stan.
Yeah. You too.
Hey, mister, are you a real cop?
Yeah, I'd like to think so.
That's what I wanted to be when I grew up. My uncle was one.
Oh, yes? Something tells me you'd make a much better cop than me.
You really think that?
Yeah, I do.
I don't know. My mom says it's not the right job for me. World's too big and too mean for all of us.
Yeah, I think your mom's right.